welcome to my channel. I am so happy you decided to watch this video. So for today, I thought we would do a demo and review of the new Per and Barbie collection round two. Now this collection is a very big collection. I know they have a brush set. I think they have a setting spray. There's some lip glosses and something else that I can't quite remember what it is. But I was able to pick up two of the lipsticks, the brand new highlighter here. I picked up the blush palette and I picked up the eyeshadow palette, which is the main, I guess, baby of this thing. So this is round two for Per and Barbie. They did come out with a collection, I believe it was last year. I did pick up some of the lipsticks that they had, and then I kind of waited around for the palette to go on sale. So I ended up with two of the lipsticks and the palette from last year. I know they did have a highlighter too, but that one to me just looked way too dark for my skin tone. So I just didn't end up picking it up. And I know it's terrible, but I definitely have a FOMO. So I did pick up the highlighter here. And then you'll see later on my thoughts on the color of this and everything. But I just want to show you guys the comparison between the 2020 version and this is the 2019 version. You can see the 19 version collection had more of that baby pink vibe to it, while this one has more of a hot pink vibe. This one does have a raised glitter texture on it, but the glitter does not come off at all, so you don't have to worry about it getting anywhere. But this is what the palette looks like there. It's very cute, hot pink. And then of course you guys have probably seen it already, but here is last year's version. So here is them compared. And I do believe that the 19 version is just a little bit bigger than the 2020 version, only by just a little bit. So they're not too different in size. This is what the last year's palette, the 2019 I believe palette, looked like. I liked it, but I felt like it was filled with a little too many shimmers. I'm not a super fan of doing an all shimmer look all the time. I like to have mattes and then just mix the two together, or just like doing an all matte look. But this is what the new 2020 palette looks like. So this time they have triangle and diamond shaped pans in them. They do have a nice array of mattes and shimmers there. The older packaging, this one here, did come with a pressed glitter, which is right there up top, but the newer palette doesn't come with any pressed glitters. So that is what the palette looks like. I just wanted to compare the two. And then later on, as you'll see, once I apply the lipsticks, that I will compare both the 2019 Barbie lipstick packaging with the new 2020 version packaging. So if you're interested in seeing the eye look that I come up with using the round two Barbie collection with Per, then just keep on watching. Alright, so eyes are already prepped and primed. I would tell you guys the shade names that I'm dipping into, but honestly, the back sticker on the back of the palette is so kind of hard to read. I don't know if I'm on the right side or not, because they're the same triangle shapes as like the pans and stuff. So I'm just going to take this yellow shade and buff that into my crease, and then I will blend it out. And then once that's all blended out, I really want to dip into this pink right here to give it more of a pinky, like yellowy orange glow to it. Now, the one thing I'll say about the pinks in this palette are you think that they're gonna be like a brighter pink, but they're just kind of muted. So we're just gonna pop that back into the crease right on top of that yellow shade and blend it up into it. We'll be right back.
So midway through blending, I realized I wanted to do more of like an orange into pink look. So I'm gonna dip into that bright orange shade and place that right on top of the pink where the yellow was. And then I'm gonna blend that orange shade into the pink shade and build up the pink too. Now, once those are nicely blended, I'm gonna dip into that kind of darker pink shade right there at the bottom. And I'm gonna place that in my outer V and also into my inner corner. I was trying to create more of a halo eye since I do need some practice on halo eyes, but I'm just gonna be packing that into the outer V and the inner corner and then kind of blending them slowly into the middle so I get a nice kind of gradient going. All right, so a little makeup talk time, I guess. So this collection I ordered when it was available for Diamond members, early access, and I got a tracking number hours after I had placed the order, but for a week it was never updated. It just always said that UPS was awaiting the item or something. So I called Ulta and they said like, yeah, I guess UPS lost your package, so we'll just send you out a whole new package. But then literally the next day, the package, the original package, was in my mailbox. So it kind of sucks, but I guess I have an extra palette and blush palette coming from the Per and Barbie collection, which I would like to do a giveaway for you guys. I think if I can reach, you know, like 100 subscribers, which would be so awesome, like so awesome, I'll do a giveaway of the collection, because I certainly don't need 2 blush palettes and 2 highlighter palettes. I just don't need the extra items, and I would like to give back to you guys. So definitely subscribe to my channel. It means the world to me. You guys have no idea. And yeah, hopefully we can hit our goal and I can do a giveaway of the Per and Barbie collection. So I'm gonna dip into my first shimmer shade, which is that burgundy shimmer, and I'm gonna place it right next to that darker pink shade, just to help blend the two into each other. And then I'll place a brighter shimmer shade into the center to give it that nice halo eye. All right, so just to create that halo eye effect, I'm gonna dip into that nice kind of silver champagne shade and place that right into the center. And then of course, blend that into the darker shimmer. And then I'll also, just to finish up kind of blending and making sure that everything looks very pigmented and blended, I'm gonna dip back into that really dark pink shade and buff that into the darker shimmer shade. Thank you. All right, so now just to finish off the eye, I'm going to smoke out that orange shade on the bottom lash line, and then I'm gonna dip into the darker brown shade that's next to it and put that right on top of it. After that, I'll just apply some eyeliner and some lashes off camera, and you guys can see the final look. All right, so moving on to the face products in the collection, I put the camera a little bit closer to my face just because I thought you guys would be able to see the better application and everything. I've already bronzed, but I'm going into the blush palette, and this is what the outer packaging looks like. It's very cute, and it kind of has that cutout kind of Barbie logo. And this is what the packaging looks like for the blush palette. Very cute, comes with that gold Per X Barbie name, and there is the back of the blush palette. And here's what the inside of the palette looks like. They do have these kind of, horizontal, I guess, I don't know my shapes, but these kind of funky pans. It does come with 6 blushes that range from lighter to deeper shades. So I'm gonna be dipping into the lighter shade first. This is a Real Techniques blush brush that I use. Just dipping into that pink shade and placing that onto my cheeks and blending it out. So these blushes are super pigmented. I did not expect them to be that pigmented. I'm definitely gonna have to go in with a beauty blender with some leftover foundation to help blend it into my skin. But they are blending out very beautifully, just very pigmented. So please go light-handed with them. And just because we have kind of an orangey look, I'm gonna dip into that lightest shade of orange right there and then place that on top of the pink. Again, these blushes are very pigmented. As you can see, I've totally gone overboard with it, but don't worry. I do go in with the beauty blender and blend that out, but yes. Definitely, again, please go light-handed with these. All right, so now that we have fixed up the blush palette, I'm going into the highlighter now. This is what the outer packaging looks like. It comes in the gold and pink, and it still has that Barbie cutout. This is what the back looks like, so you can see what the highlighter looks like before buying it. And this is what the actual packaging of the highlighter looks like. Of course, it still has that glitter raised texture to it, but you don't have to worry about any glitters falling off. It still has that really cute gold kind of imprint, I guess, of it. and that's the imprint of the highlighter palette inside. I really love the imprint. I love that they put Barbie in this one. I'm just so sad that I'm gonna have to basically destroy her by putting this on. So first I went in with just the gold side of the highlighter. And then after that, I will jump into just the pink side of the highlighter. And lastly, I did a mixture of both of the highlighters, just so you guys can see what the color looks like. Honestly, the gold one is just a nice gold shade. The pink does have a pink and gold reflect to it. And really just mixing the two colors together just give you a very amplified kind of pink and gold highlighter. So once I have both the pink side and the gold side of the highlighter applied, hopefully you guys can see it. You can tell that it is a very dark highlighter. Even blended out, I still have that kind of harsh pigment line to it. So definitely if you are my skin tone or lighter, this is going to be a super dark highlighter for you. It's gorgeous, but it definitely works better for medium to darker skin tones. Alright, so now that we have the highlighter on, I'm going to be moving on to the lipsticks. I do have the two nude shades that they had. They do come in different packaging, which I didn't expect. I thought they'd have the same packaging overall, but they do have the shade names and the shade colors up top. One is pink and one is gold. If you flip it over, it does have the ingredients. And from the side, you do have one that's got a pink box and one that has a red box. This is what the component looks like out of the packaging. I don't really know what you would call this kind of texture. It's not a glitter, but it's also not like diamonds, but it's so cute. I love when brands do packaging like this, very unique components. Comparing the 2019 version to the 2020 version, the 2019 version is more of a kind of box octagon shape to it, and baby pink has a nice fade. The tops of them, these are the buttons that you would click to get the lipstick out, are different. As you can see, I do like the Barbie head better. And of course, one is silver and one is gold. So you would click the top of the button right there and the lipsticks will pop out, which I think is a super cool feature for both of them. And the actual lipstick components here, you can see one is silver, one is gold. And the 2019 version, now they did have a glitter overspray to them, but the 2020 version is just a all matte lipstick. You can see there is a very cute Barbie head on them. I did swatch the nude shades that I had. The bottom two shades are from the 2019 collection, and the top ones are from the 2020 collection. So there are some different shades in the collection. I'm super sad to ruin the Barbie head on top of the lipstick. Who can say where the road goes, where the day flows, only time. So as you can see, my lipstick totally fell out of the component, and I don't know why it did that. It broke right at the bottom, but that's not gonna stop me. So I just stuck it back in. That's so sad that that happened. I'm just gonna wear the lighter shade of lipstick, but I don't know why that happened. That's so sad. Please let me know if you guys ordered from this collection and your lipsticks have done that. Oh my God. Alright guys, and this is the completed look using the Per X Barbie collection. We're not gonna stay too long on this because once you look at yourself for too long, then you're like, what the hell? So let's go on and jump on into the review of this.
Alright guys, and that is the finished tutorial using the almost entire Per X Barbie collection round 2, the 2020 version, I guess, if you want to say it. Just a quick recap, I really liked the palette. I think the mattes performed absolutely beautifully and the shimmers are gorgeous as well. My only tiff is the packaging and what they've done with the eyeshadow palette. I am just not a fan of brands putting in wonky kind of eyeshadow pans like this. I just think that they're really hard to get into and get the color out. So I wish they had done just a normal traditional palette. But besides that, if you can get over the odd shape of the pans, I definitely recommend picking the eyeshadow up. The same with the blush palette. I actually really loved the blush palette. Again, don't really like the oddly shaped pans. I wish brands wouldn't do that because you kind of saw that once I dipped into one shade, some of the pigments started getting into the one right next to it, and I'd like to keep them separate because I don't want to mix my blushes all the time, and I feel like that's gonna happen if you kind of end up getting some fallout into the other one. But packaging aside, the formulation of these blushes are really beautiful. They are so pigmented, as you saw. You really need to go in with a light hand with these, otherwise you're gonna have a lot of color on your cheeks and it can go overboard fast. But I feel like because of the pigmentation and using a little bit less than what you usually would, I think these are gonna last you a very long time. Outer packaging of the palette, I absolutely love. It's a great size to throw in your makeup bag on the go if you're traveling. So I definitely think that the palette is a must have. Moving on to the highlighter. Again, I'm just gonna say it, I love the packaging on all of the products. I loved the imprint that they have too of the Barbie face. I think that's super pretty. I actually liked the imprint and size and shape of this highlighter better than their past highlighters. And the stones on the top are really cute, but for some reason I love the circular packaging on this guy. Plus the fact that Barbie is actually imprinted, even though I have a love-hate relationship with brands that do that because I love the imprint. It's so cute, but at the same time, if I'm going to use the product, I'm going to destroy the imprint, and then it's kind of a waste. But as far as the highlighter, it's a very gorgeous beaming highlighter right off the bat, and if you build it up, you can get that blinding highlight. Now, my only tiff with this one is if you're my skin tone or even lighter, you're going to have a really hard time trying to blend this into your skin tone. As you saw on this side, once I started to build it up, you can see that kind of color line on my face where the pigment is. I think if you're medium to darker skin tone, this is gonna look absolutely gorgeous on you. So it's just kind of a warning to anybody lighter or the same shade as me, just to be careful with this. I'd probably go light-handed. It is a very dark highlighter. So if you're interested in the Barbie collection, definitely pick this up because the imprint on it is so stinking cute. So, and then last but not least, we have the Per and Barbie lipsticks. Again, packaging on this is 10 out of 10. I love that you just push the button and it pops out. Now, as you guys saw when I was filming the tutorial, that my lipstick just broke off. I'm not sure if there's something going on with the lipstick or if it's just mine, like it stayed out in the heat too long or something, but that was kind of upsetting and super scary. So definitely check and make sure that yours doesn't do that, and to contact Per if you end up with a lipstick like mine. Otherwise, it's a beautiful matte formula. I will say that the lipstick is a little drying on my lips. I have had more comfortable matte lipsticks before. The color is gorgeous though. I feel like maybe just putting on a gloss, I can get through the day wearing this. But honestly, I'll probably just keep these more as just like a collector item and stuff, just like my other ones, and just rarely use it. For review purposes, I think that if you really enjoy the packaging on these lipsticks and you collect Barbie stuff, as I've said multiple times throughout this video, definitely pick these up. But if you're mostly into the formula, I would probably pass on these. There's way more comfortable matte lipsticks out on the market, so I think these could be a pass. So again, I think the collection is really gorgeous. I would love to try out the setting spray that they have in that classic kind of perfume bottle, and definitely the brushes. The brushes look really gorgeous too, with the diamond bow on them. So I do plan on checking those out probably later on in the year. So leave a like down on this video. It really helps me out. Comment down below what you guys think of the Per and Barbie collection. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see the next time that I upload. And hopefully you guys will be here for the Per x Barbie giveaway that I'll end up doing. So until next time, I hope you guys have a beautiful day, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.